The C-36 and C-38 class would vie very closely as being the most prestigious and aesthetically pleasing express passenger locomotives ever to operate on the railways of New South Wales. The first of the C-36 class 460s were introduced in 1925 and were designed by Mr. E.E. Lucy, the chief mechanical engineer, and his department at Everly Works. 10 locomotives were constructed at the works, whilst a further 65 were built by Clyde Engineering Company, the last of these entering service in 1928. After early teething problems were rectified, the class was put to work on the state's top passenger duties, excelling themselves with their free steaming and fuel economy. The locos also earned the nickname pigs due to their humpback boiler and snout-like front end. The 36s were preceded by the 35 or NN class 460s, on whose design they were based. As a result, the two locomotive types had a certain similarity of appearance. A feature of the design of the 36s was the Walsh Hartz valve gear, operating outside piston valves and superheating. The locomotives also had turret tenders, which resulted in a very large coal and water capacity. Initially, the class was fitted with a round-top boiler design, but from 1953, all but two of the 36s were rebuilt with bell pair boilers and other improvements, increasing their weight marginally to just over 160 tonnes. The attractive effort from £30,500 to just under £34,000. In 1957, 3616 was fitted with a Giesel oblong ejector. This significantly improved the locomotive's power output and fuel efficiency. However, because of the advent of diesel motive power, no other members of the class were modified in this way. 3616 is seen departing Newcastle in August 1970 with a passenger train for Gosford. The same train passes Adamstown. By the early 1960s, as their use on passenger turns dwindled, the 36s were increasingly used on various freight duties, including banking work, again performing with distinction, until they were finally withdrawn from regular traffic at the end of the decade. 3638 is seen near Wellington in June 1965. The 3675 pilots an unidentified 60-class Garratt on a freight working between Nashdale and Orange. 3646 and 3803 work a coal train over Hawk Mount, heading south in November 1967. The following sequences were filmed during the early 1960s. 3675 climbs Raglan Bank east of Bathurst on the main western line with a freight. 'Ably assisted by a 280 standard goods loco. The Up Central West Express arrives at Bathurst with 3639 in charge. A view from the loco cab sees the train approach Raglan Bank. Six assists a Garratt with a load of zinc concentrate from Broken Hill on the western line between Parkes and Molong. And approaching Molong. A 36 at speed near Gerogery on the connecting service from Albury to Junee to meet with the air-conditioned Riverina Express to Sydney. Again at Gerogery, 3624, with a northbound freight. Humble duties again for a 36, with a down stock train through Maitland, heading for Werris Creek. So successful were the 36 class that the design was adopted by the Commonwealth Railways in 1938 to work crack expresses such as the Trans-Australia Express. Walkers of Queensland was the successful tenderer, constructing eight of the type to become Commonwealth Railways C class. In order to increase water and fuel capacity, immense six-wheel bogie tenders were incorporated, as well as other minor adaptations, the more obvious of which were high-mounted smoke deflectors. With the arrival of General Motors diesels from 1951, the C-class were gradually phased out, and all were taken out of service by the late 1950s. In New South Wales, however, as the final locos were taken out of service, 3642 was saved from the cutter's torch and preserved in operational condition. It is based at the New South Wales Rail Transport Museum at Thirlmere, along with non-operational sister locos 3609 and the unique Giesel ejector loco 3616. Museum member Ray Love explains the principle of this unique engine.
And this is locomotive 3616, which is in the collection of the Rail Museum at Thirlmere. This engine is quite unique with the collection and the New South Wales Railways. It's the only one fitted with what is termed a Giesel oblong ejector. The Giesel oblong ejector is actually the blast pipe arrangements whereby seven individual blasts of steam through the ports as shown here is obtained by exhausting from the cylinders. Normally a steam locomotive has one port which blasts up through the chimney. This particular engine with a Giesel ejector has seven individual ports. The idea being a greater, smaller blast can be obtained when the steam engine exhausts from the cylinders. It gives a greater draft on the fire and increased boiler efficiency, reduced coal consumption. It is, however, tied in with changed drafting arrangements, different dampers, different smoke box arrangement, and different spark arrestor arrangement. Very common in Europe. New South Wales Railways only had one locomotive, this being it. We'll now compare the Giesel ejector system of seven individual blasts to a conventional locomotive in the collection. This is the locomotive 3642 in the collection of the Rail Museum at Thirlmere, and this is a conventional style of smoke box fitted to 36 class engines and most other New South Wales locomotives. We're looking now at the ends of the boiler tubes where the hot gases and fire pass through into this area here called the smoke box. On 3616, the Giesel style, the blast pipe in front of us here was actually seven individual openings aimed up the chimney. This is a conventional style that has the one blast pipe opening and the gases from the fire come into this area here. The exhaust from the cylinders passes up the single opening, causes a turbulence in here, and there's ashes and debris is collected by the spark arrestor that we're looking at.
Despite the success of the 36 class, the upgrading of the Melbourne Limited with new luxury sleeping carriages demanded motive power capable of greater speed with heavier loads. Locomotives able to manage the Melbourne Express unassisted the entire length of the Sydney-Albury line were required. The C-38 class, emerging from Clyde Engineering in 1943, was hailed as the answer to the problem. The Pacific was a major departure in design, developed under the leadership of the chief mechanical engineer, Harold Young. The 462 wheel arrangement permitted a much larger grate area in comparison to the existing 460s. Other improvements were the use of box-poc driving wheels, roller-bearing axle boxes, power reversers, and high-capacity tenders maximising fuel availability. The first five Clyde engines were semi-streamlined with a distinctive Cyclops Eye headlight set in the bulbous smoke box front, a trend influenced by American practices of the time. The second batch of 25 locomotives, however, were non-streamlined. These were constructed in the railway departmental workshops, 13 at Everly and 12 at Cardiff, the last of the class entering service in 1949. Wartime austerity measures dictated grey livery, the 38s during this period becoming known as grey nurses. Verdant green livery followed in post-war years. With all but 3813 trading this striking colour scheme for standard black. ...3801 and 3830 were returned to green livery during the 1960s. Weighing weighing around 200 tonnes and with a tractive effort of over 36,000 pounds, the class boasted 245 pounds boiler pressure, the highest of any loco in Australia. During the 1960s, like their 36-class predecessors, the 38s were gradually superseded on express passenger duties and performed sterling work on fast goods. One notable passenger express, however, the Sydney to Newcastle Flyer, remained a Pacific duty in the Gosford-Newcastle section until the end of the decade. Midday Flyer departs Newcastle during the mid-1960s, behind 3664. At this time, 36s were a rarity on this working, and 3664 was probably deputising for a 38-class failure. Afternoon Flyer, headed by 3827, in August 1969. The northbound Southern Highlands Express arrives at Campbelltown in 1962, behind 3808. The same northbound service is seen near Douglas Park, with 3803 in charge. And passing Menangle Park. The 1960s saw the historic extension of electrification from Hornsby to Gosford. To commemorate the occasion, an official ceremony was held at Gosford Station on the 23rd of January. As 3813 handed over the up midday Newcastle Flyer to a 46-class electric for the run to Sydney. The Australian Railway Historical Society also staged their own last steam train to Gosford on the same day. And vintage 440s, numbers 1210 and 1243, hauled the special working from Sydney. Early morning at Goulburn during 1962 sees the arrival of the Up Melbourne Express, consisting of over 500 tonnes behind a 38, with a 36 assisting. testament to the power and efficiency of the 38s, as the same train, after dropping off the pilot loco, lifts the load out of Goulburn. The Southern Highlands Express, X5:06 p.m. from Sydney, departs Strathfield behind a well-turned-out 38, again during 1962. A school special from Sydney, with the first steam haul train to Cronulla, sees 3803 climbing the grade between Jenali and Sutherland. And climbing Garnier Bank on the 10th of March, 1962. The changeover from steam to diesel traction in the 1960s resulted in many spectacular Last of Steam specials. On this occasion, the imminent dieselisation of the Tumut-Batlow branch was heralded by a number of steam locomotives, including 3830 and 3813. The vintage train event run by the Department of Railways in 1962 spanned several days, departing from Sydney on the 30th of March and returning on the 1st of April. At Cootamundra, the 38s were replaced by vintage 440s, 1219 and 1709, which took the train to Tumut. From Tumut, veteran 060s 1901 and 1954 took over, hauling the train on the steep and winding route to Batlow. The return saw 3243 and 1709 take over from Cootamundra to Harden. 2532 then took charge to Boorowa and return. And 1709 again took over as far as Goulburn, with a stop at Yass Junction, where 1311 took a short train to Yass Town and return. From Goulburn back to Sydney, 3810 took charge. Without doubt, The most exciting railway event of 1962 was the delivery run of the standard gauge Spirit of Progress from Melbourne to Sydney. 3813 and 3830 were dispatched to Albury on the 13th of April with a special train which ran to the timetable of the Melbourne Express. The Spirit cars were run up from Melbourne behind S-Class number 313 on the 14th of April and stowed at Albury, where the next day, at 6:20 a.m, the two green 38s took the Spirit of Progress on its run to Sydney. En route, at Tabletop near Albury, the Spirit crosses 3801, hauling the Melbourne Limited Express, on a specially rostered steam working from Junee to Albury. A service stop was made at Wagga Wagga Station. Wagga Wagga Viaduct is crossed. Water is taken at Junee. Climbing Bathungra Spiral. Summit. Goonda Curve. Climbing Gunning Bank. Razorback, en route Goulburn. Despite delays for photo stops, servicing and signal checks, the run between Albury and Sydney was completed in 12 hours 13 minutes. Another special with the 238 class variants. ...3804 leads 3813 on a tour train through Penrith during the mid-1960s. The year is 1963, and 3825 heads a train through Yerrangool en route to Moss Vale. Always popular on rail tour duty, 3813 is seen between Dungog and Gloucester en route to Taree in 1970 on such a special. And rural locations further north. During September 1970, on what was to become one of several visits of both 36s and 38s to South Australia, 3801 and 3813 hauled the Western Endeavour en route to Perth. Thank you. On reaching Port Pirie, 3813 was detached and 3801 continued westward on its historic journey. Whilst in South Australia, 3813 worked a number of specials along with South Australia's broad gauge loco number 526. On such a diagram en route to Port Augusta, 3813 is seen at Membrey Creek. At Nectar Brook. And arriving at Port Augusta. Another special behind 3813 headed west along the Nullarbor Plain from Port Augusta as far as Tent Hill. Further special operations ran between Port Pirie and Gladstone. The northbound Newcastle Flyer behind 3813 is seen at Narara, north of Gosford. And again between Wyong and Morisset in the mid-1960s. On withdrawal from regular service, 3813 survived the cutter's torch, but is now in parts which are scattered around in different locations. 3801, however, survived into active preservation and is the flagship loco for 3801 Limited. Whilst 3830, owned by the Powerhouse Museum in Sydney, has also been fully restored to operational condition. One other class member still exists, 3820, which is preserved on static display at the New South Wales Rail Transport Museum at Thirlmere. We now take a look at a number of other special workings featuring both 36 and 38 class locos. October 1972 saw the opening of the Port Augusta to Whyalla standard gauge link to the then Commonwealth Railway system. The New South Wales Rail Transport Museum organised the first steam train to traverse the new line, emanating from Sydney. Locos in charge of the special train were 3642 and 3801. The doubleheader is seen at Dowds Hill near Peterborough. On reaching Port Augusta, the two locos were separated and worked a series of specials individually. 3642 is seen crossing the head of Spencer's Gulf between Port Augusta and Whyalla. The Melbourne Steam Festival of 1973 saw 3801 and 3820 dispatched from Sydney to participate in the Victorian celebrations. The pair are seen at Culcairn between Junee and Albury. Victorian Railways R707 and the 238s shared duties near Seymour during the celebrations. This included spectacular parallel running along broad and standard gauge tracks on the main northern line. More recently, during the Australian Bicentenary celebrations in 1988, 3801 again paid a visit to Victoria. She's seen here at Wollan, heading north. Again near Broadford. again heading north, vying for attention with Victorian Railway's R707. During one of an increasing number of visits to Victoria, Easter 1992 sees 3642 heading north at Heathcote Junction. Again at Seymour. And at Albury. A visit during Easter of 1993 and 3801 parallels in spectacular fashion with Victorian broad gauge locos R766 and K183 between Kilmore and Seymour. Thank you. end this video program, we take a special look at the Belmont branch line. With historic footage from the last days of steam operation. The Belmont line south of Newcastle was unique in traversing industrial, rural wetlands and coastal landscape. Usual motive power on the branch passenger service during the 1960s were the 30-class 464 Baltic tank locomotives. On this occasion, the 30th of April 1967, 3138 takes charge of the daily return service from Newcastle. Leaving Newcastle at 12:28 p.m, the usual two-coach train rolls into Adamstown at 12:40 p.m. before leaving the main line. Fernley Tunnel is the next landmark, before passing Fernley Loop signal box. Goods trains often crossed here, as in this case, hauled by a 48-class diesel electric loco. Brief stop is made at Dudley. Burwood Colliery can be seen before passing Cahaba Station and stopping at Whitebridge. This station was notable in having the only woman station master in New South Wales. A leisurely departure takes the train through Whitebridge Cutting and the approach to Redhead. Redhead Station, and 3138 takes a well-earned drink. Coastal wetlands are now passed as the train skirts the Pacific Ocean. Belmont Station is reached on time at 1:05 p.m. The tank engine runs around the train before the return run, chimney first. First stop out from Belmont is Jules Crossing, an on-request halt. And onwards towards Whitebridge. Burwood Colliery is again passed before a brief stop at Burwood Junction, a station built by the colliery. Through Fernley Tunnel once again, before rejoining the main line at Adamstown. The final steam-hauled passenger train to Belmont was on the 13th of May 1967, before a rail motor took over the duty. The branch finally closed on the 8th of April, 1971.